when I came out in football last season, I got a lot of media attention because I was the first transgender woman to work in the Premier League. I'm constantly getting asked when a player might come out as gay. And to tell the truth, I don't actually know. But now a filmmaker's produced a film explaining what it might be like for an England international to come out as gay. So what is Wonderkid about?
So Wonderkid follows a fictional professional footballer as he's just made a move to a top Premier League club, and we follow him in the really important 2 weeks of his life where he makes the move and makes his debut and then makes his England debut at the end of the film. But moving to London, he is exposed to more and more of London's kind of gay culture, and he starts to question why he can't come out as a gay man. And we look at the challenges faced by a professional footballer wanting to come out in football.
How close do you think we are to actually a gay player coming out?
It's a hotly debated thing. I don't think we're that far away, but you only need to look at, you know, social media and the fans on match day to see why there aren't any top level male professionals currently playing. So, I mean, it only takes one person to take that step, but how far away we are from that step, we won't know, because it's a very personal decision.
We've got a lot of out gay women's players. Why do you think it's so different in the women's game?
I think that there still are problems in the women's game, but obviously there are many more out players playing in the women's game. I think if you consider hypermasculinity is all about acting tough and not showing any emotion, and the environment in male football is so not politically correct, I think it's harder in the male's game. But yeah, women certainly are leading the way with it.
Did you actually experience any difficulties or obstructions when you're trying to make this film?
Yeah, it was very difficult to get anyone to talk to me about it, you know, when I first started 3 years ago. But you know, gradually as the project gained momentum, more people were willing to support it and help. But we haven't really had any contact with any professional footballers, obviously. And all our research was done through kind of grassroots gay football and LGBT fan groups.
So just a ball game, it raises awareness and around homophobia in the game, but also around LGBT inclusion and visibility. Basically, we exist to show that you can use football and other sports as an educational tool to counteract anybody's fears that they have around anything that's anti-gay, especially young people these days.
And how big a problem do you think that homophobia still is in the game?
It's still a massive problem. Not everything's reported. Sadly, it's also creeping into the women's game now and has been for a few years. It's getting a little bit more prominent in those areas because the women's game's expanding and there's the crossover where others are coming to watch what's going on in the women's game, and little bits of homophobia are slipping in there. So it's got to be nipped in the bud as much as we can.
And what plans have you got for Wonderkid in the future?
So we're holding a premiere in the end of September, which we'll be announcing at the end of the week. And then there'll be a number of screenings between then and the end of the year, and it'll be launched online for free with the aim of getting it to as many people as possible and get people not only thinking about this subject and talking about it, but to change their opinions about it, you know, because we've created an inspiring character that male football is not quite ready for.
Are you hoping that the film will actually change people's attitudes towards a gay player coming out?
Yeah, I think so. You know, because we don't know who the gay footballers playing are, no one will really be exposed to what they would go through as they struggle trying to come out in football. And this will not only make people sympathise with that character, but, you know, want to see gay footballers come out, I think, you know, because he's an inspiring character. To put a face on all the insults and the face on the behaviour that people haven't really been forced to kind of change.
What are you doing in there?
I thought you wanted to be a footballer.
I am a footballer.
One day, all that'll matter is I'm the best this country's ever seen.
This is Sophie Cook for latest TV news here in Leicester Square.